Have you ever heard of decision fatigue? Like downloading 1,000 games for $5 and not knowing which one to play? Well, if you haven't experienced it before, you're about to. Hey guys, welcome to another episode of The Miller Effect. I'm your host, Devonte Chisholm. And if you're new here, go down below, hit that sub button, hit the like button early in the video. Why not? And let's get into it and let's talk about Destiny 2. Yesterday, Destiny revealed the Beyond Light expansion, as well as the titles of the expansions for 2021 and 2022. So will I jump back into Destiny 2? Less than likely, but comment down below if you want to carry me. And speaking of that Destiny reveal, Bungie started off their live stream with a Black Lives Matter call to action. So big shout out to them for using their platform and their big announcement to spread awareness. I'm proud. And now let's switch gears to Last of Us, because yesterday PlayStation launched an official podcast for the game. The project will be an 8-episode series hosted by writer and stand-up comedian Christian Spicer, and will explore the development of both titles. The first episode is out right now, so once this video is over, go check it out. I haven't checked it out yet, but I'm gonna get around to it. Maybe after I play Last of Us Part 2. And speaking of Last of Us Part 2, Neil Druckmann opened up to GQ recently and revealed he doesn't know if he wants to make a Part 3 or if they should just explore a new IP. Now, I want to weigh in on this more, but I want to wait until after I play Last of Us Part 2 to see if it ends in a way that, like, makes me want a Part 3, or if it's similar to the first Last of Us where it ended and I was just like, okay, it's kind of open-ended the way it ended, in an Inception type of way, but I like that. We don't need a continuation of the story. Let my mind wander and just let it be what it is. So if Part 2 is like that, then I'm probably, I don't know. Because look at this, I was one of the people that didn't want Part 2, but now that Part 2 is around the corner, I'm excited for it. So Part 3 could be around the corner again sometime in the future, and I could be excited for that. Who knows? I guess we'll have to just wait and see. But hey, remember that PlayStation 5 event last week that was delayed? Well, it's back on. It's tomorrow, 4 p.m. Eastern. That's my time. So do the math and figure out when your time zone is gonna have it showing. And if all things work out perfectly for me, you're gonna have a reaction video from me right here on this channel sometime later in the day, so you can get my thoughts on the preview of the 3D audio, because they said to wear headphones during it, so I'm assuming we're gonna get a preview of the 3D audio. And last but not least, there is a massive itch.io bundle going on where you can get over 1,000 games for $5. I'm gonna say it again, over 1,000 games for $5. I know I'm holding up two hands and that makes 10, but for $5. And that's just the minimum donation. So go crazy, donate as much as you want. All proceeds go towards the NCAA Legal Defense and Educational Fund, as well as the Community Bail Fund. At the time of this recording, they've raised over $3 million. And there's a lot of great games in this bundle, a lot of games that you haven't heard of and some games that are critically acclaimed and you've definitely heard of. It's well worth the $5 or whatever you decide to donate. Not just for the games, but for the cause that it's for. This sale ends around Sunday or Monday, the 14th, June 14th, 15th. So jump in there. You have no excuse. You literally have no excuse. And as I said in the beginning of this video, you're gonna suffer from a little bit of decision fatigue, but it is well worth it. Head on over there, donate, get over 1,000 games and feel good about yourself. But all right guys, that is it for me. If you've made it this far, go ahead and hit that like button and the sub button if you didn't do so in the beginning of the video, and I will see you for another Miller Effect on Friday. But before then, remember, tomorrow be right back here for my reaction to the PS5 event. Peace.